how you dress. How you dress. You know what I feel like? You know when Leon Schuster never hooks vein? When I do, yes! I feel like it's that. Like I got in my puss now on that.
Hey guys, welcome to Steak Back. This is where we chill, eat, and discuss nothing but eat. Today in the building, we got the one and only Simon Orgel from the ex Sip and Simon. How are you doing?
Reasonably. How are you? Good.
Thanks for coming through,
my brother. Thank you.
Lekker. Spending your time with us. Appreciate it.
Oh yeah. I'm keen to get involved, but also to cry for those wings.
Is it?
Jeez.
You know, have you eaten side wing before?
Yeah.
Enjoy it.
Yeah. Cross gangsters are lying.
Are we? Nah, then you'll enjoy this. We're going to start off with a barbecue chipotle.
Okay.
No?
Now, face me something about this. Is it
it's chipotle and barbecue, you know. That's what I'm going to face about it.
Okay. So, is this a flatty?
It's a flatty.
Can I ask you, what's your favorite one? The flats or the drummies?
Drummies is the best.
Trail.
There's meat on here.
Mm.
Now, you generally were spicy.
Yo, it differs, okay.
Mm.
Sometimes I'm steak, but most of the times I'm in a week now.
Toilet paper in the freezer type of vibe.
But I see this milky, so salute for that.
Nah, you're all good. Simon, you got some beautiful content that you shared with our people in South Africa. Funny stuff, relatable stuff on Sip and Simon. What was the birth of that? Where did it come from?
Sure. That started about 2.5 years ago. I phoned Sip. I said, do you want to do some content and stuff? Because I just wanted to write mad stuff. And from there, we just kind of learned everything. And then we got to the point where we were up until last week. And then, we kind of just had to stop. But it was cuck fun, though. I mean, the Art Moments Dance Academy.
Oh, yes.
Types of colors, types of safers. I still remember we made saping trend in South Africa on Twitter. And we also made a yacht trend in South Africa as well, which is cut funny because normally topical things trend, but we took push of the whole thing and we made our own way and the whole of Cape Town got involved in South Africa. So it was a lekker journey and just dancing with like Africa Blazing Cut and shooting with young Mr. Mayer over there and Rolo as well sitting in the back and you and I
chasing
hotline.
Young Fabian from the streets.
How much fun is that though?
It was indeed. And I mean, the people put, you know what I mean, and they enjoyed it themselves. Okay, so I think we can dive into the next wing. This is called Bloody Mary.
Bloody Mary.
But there's vodka in it and that's all I know, alright?
I'm fighting with this thing.
You chatted about, your content and stuff like that with Sippy. Can you tell us more about why? Are you guys just taking a break? Is it a gimmick? You coming back with fucking anything hard?
Now we're coming back with doing a rebrand. We're coming back as Simon and Sip. I'm sure. But it's all about what we want to do next, I think. And that was he's always been on the position that he wants to do more like music videos. Because he's really passionate about music, which is something I think everybody knows about him. With the stream as well, and they blowing up. So I can understand that he wants to be more on that side of things, where I always wanted to do more of the writing and creative side of it. It's not to say that that isn't creative, I'm not saying that at all, but what I am saying is that it's just time to become our own people as well and concentrate on what we really wanted to concentrate on. And I mean, that's important for everybody as well. So we amicable because we knew that we did the cuck, man.
Yeah.
We trained and we had daily retweets, daily shares. It doesn't actually fucking matter. At the beginning we thought, okay, you know, now we have to do things a certain way. But then at the end we were like, everyone's boost basically because we're gonna do what we wanna do. And we had so much fun dancing and all this cuck that it is sad if I thought, like when I thought about it immediately afterwards, I was like, yo. Never gonna dance again. Singing on stage at Clubbers Camp, Buzerik was dancing there as well. And then we were also like at Twilight Team Run with Devin. And it was fun, you know. Who can actually say that they got to do all their cut? Just as two cutted lighties lumming with a camera and having fun. We are still brasser, we still Taylor. We will still save together. Nothing's really changed. But we're still going to be doing our own kak, and we still will lean on each other. Okay, cool. We've learned a lot.
The next one is called a mango habanero.
This was for sale last week at Sidewing, if I'm correct.
It was. And?
I don't have it, because it sold out so fast.
Oh. My beard is full of orange now.
Oh, this is interesting.
Mango.
Ooh.
What?
It's hot.
Really?
Just come in.
That's a good thing though.
The doctors didn't know what was wrong with me. Whew.
But like,
you see,
I saw some stuff about the Kakprat show. Yourself, Yas and Barnes. Who else was involved here?
And Kenwin David.
Yes, Kenwin.
Sorry to your viewers, because he comes his ear now. I promise you. It's gonna get worse if this is gonna, if I'm starting at number 3 and the hiccups are starting. And look how you just. You know what I feel like? You know when Leon Schuster never hooks vein? When they do it. Yes! I feel like it's that. Like I got in my puss now on that. Oh! Okay. What are we talking about?
The Kakprat show.
Yeah.
Want to give us a bit of spoilers? Or not spoilers, just a bit of a trailer, maybe.
Now, I love talking kak, just making up stuff on the fly. And that was an opportunity to do that because I just put a green screen now. I come up with a concept, okay, here's a question. And I got into kak with my tani because she was very upset because we did things you don't say at a funeral. And then we were saying the worst things possible. But it's only in jest, you know, it's not meant to be taken seriously. My mom is very conservative. She doesn't like it that I swear or type or anything. So we came out, we had some fire lines there, and yeah, she was very concerned. But it was very funny because one thing I said was, "Damn you, Eunice, you swine." And she was like, "You know, that when the Jacksons died, they wanted those kids to Michael Jackson and his family, and they see this and they see this." I said, "There's no ways Michael Jackson's family is watching Stephen Simon or Simon Wachel's cuck from America." Firstly, they didn't know what the fuck kind of cuck is.
But that's just true, yeah. Lingo. So, some information.
It's just like a Hulk one.
Yeah, I think we should call this the Hulk one. This is a nice one. This is a jalapeno and garlic. So, it's pretty good.
It's very garlic, you know. The heat quality is much more dumber, you know?
Yeah.
That middle one really scooped me banana in there.
Yeah. It's throwing Spanish in the works. Tell us about life growing up. Where did you grow up? Where did you come from? Did you play sport? What school did you go to?
So, I'm from Heathfield in the southern suburbs. That's like, you don't know actually what you are because you got Middleditch on the one side and you got your Retreat and Steam on the other side. Then you feel like you are stervy colored because you kind of all colored, but then you also wanna like act like you watch Frasier and stuff. Which I did, you know?
So you come across as someone, I'm not scowling you, kicking you by the feet, but you just come across as someone that watched Frasier.
I did watch Frasier, thank you. But you have an opportunity, it's so cack or so, because, and I'm gonna talk about something else now completely, because you grow up colored now, and then you somehow do well, or you start changing like in a better way, like you're not the same as you were before. And people somehow say, nah, you don't tell up for them anymore, or you change the whole norm. Which is cuck, because what's the point of working hard and encouraging men to be creative and unique, and the fucking thing happens, and then they say, nah, this man is a puss or whatever. Now that is something that is cuck, because that's also about your suburbs, somehow. Now they say, nah, he's on Eastfield, or there's a fairways nigh there. It's really, I don't want to say that word, it's really, really dumb to consider where your area is, that you are not colored enough, or you think you're stervy, or you think you're this and that. Because I still had the same experience. We still bribed us in our bus, we saved us in our bus. My dad used to go fucking to Soetwater, and we used to go there on holiday every fucking December with old army tents and whatever. So it's frustrating sometimes being colored in that situation, because even with this area we are from, it doesn't really matter. We should actually be the same buzz, you know, except for Northern Suburbs, because they can spot.
So, shout out to the North.
And all the men said, move there also now.
Ride the camera guy. Straight out the panel.
Now we're going to, they always say, nah, but we got a liquor size property. So, now we don't bet.
That's true. Lips are right.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
My lips are burning.
Nah, it's burning. I'm just being strong for camera.
The last one.
Yeah.
It's supposed to be Buffalo Art. I say this to everyone that comes through. You normally have blue cheese dressing with it.
Okay.
So today is just straight. Leave the cheers.
Oh, we're cheersing.
Leave the blue cheese dressing for the Northern Suburbs.
Yo, it's sweet now, like when you both taste it as well.
Okay, so yeah, you made it. 5 wings deep.
Thank I you love wings much. Though. Wings is the best, honestly. So I'm gonna say thank you again as well.
You can check it that camera, this camera. Let Cape Town, South Africa, the world know what you're gonna be up to, what content you're gonna be posting, where you're gonna be. What your favorite top is, and then you can also nominate someone to come and join us on the show to come get some, to get the big steak.
Okay. All right, so I'm Simon Orgel. You can catch me on social, Simon_Orgel. Currently working on the Talk Cuck show with the High Scene Barnes and Kenman Davids, but I have some new shows also coming up. You'll see some Mal Nayas around as well. And I challenge Aurik September at Sip Tizzle to come sit here. Salute.
Thanks for coming through, bro.
Thank you.
Guys, thank you for watching. That was Simon Orgel. Check him out on the socials or platforms. Once again, shout out to Sidewind. Shout out to Sneaker Cartel. Follow them on Instagram. Follow at Steak Beck on Instagram as well. We'll catch up with you next episode. Have a good one. Safe.
Your lips is branding. Look at you. You guys. You talking and everything. You look like you could swing.
4 years. Nah, lekker man. Why did you subscribe to get notified about the next Steak Beck episode? Come on guys, click, like, subscribe.